I came to write The Ocean at the End of the Lane because I missed my wife. And she's a rock star. She was in Melbourne, Australia, making a record. And I missed her. I missed her very much. And decided I would write her a short story. And I began writing a story. And then it kept going, and it became a very long short story. And then when I finished it, it was a novel. I mined my childhood for this book. It is not autobiographical. The things that happened in here mostly didn't happen to me, and if they did happen, they didn't happen in the way that they happen in the book, or in the sequence, or in the nature. But all the way through, the narrator is me when I was 7. When I was a boy, was absolutely in love with reading. I always had a book. My parents would frisk me. They would pat me down before like weddings and family events to see if I'd hidden a book somewhere on me. And if they found a book, they would lock it in the back of the car. No, the nanny is not actually any real nanny that I had. Quite the reverse. There was an incredibly sweet, incredibly nice nanny named Anne Davidson, who I remember and who I adored, and who she had a Star Trek poster. She'd been to America, which as far as I was concerned was like going to Oz, and she'd come back with a Star Trek poster and a Star Trek book. And she took the Star Trek poster with her when she left, but she left me the Star Trek book. So I thought she was the coolest. I don't know if The Ocean at the End of the Lane has taken me to a whole different level, but it seems to have taken me to a whole different readership. I think partly because, you know, my books have sold very well over the years, but books like American Gods, have tended to sell to a specific audience of people who like sort of weird science fiction fantasy stuff. Books like Coraline and The Graveyard Book have sold incredibly well, but they've sold to, particularly in America, in France, they've sold to children. They haven't really been sold to adult readers. With Ocean at the End of the Lane, I'm finding people who I would never have thought would have liked my books are liking it, and they read it because somebody they know told them to read it. And it gets very, very strange. I was at an event recently, and I was chatting to a very nice lady in her 60s, and she said, "What do you do?" And I said, "I write books." And she said, "Anything I would have heard of?" And I said, "No." And she said, "Well, name some of the books that you've written." And I said, "Well, American Gods, and I won the Newbery Award for The Graveyard Book, and I said, "I've just done a novel called The Ocean at the End of the Lane." She said, "I'm reading that right now. It's brilliant." And it was such a surprise, because this was somebody who I would never have imagined would have read one of my books, and she was loving it. So I love that, you know, The Ocean got to spend over 4 months on the New York Times bestseller list, and that's wonderful. But what I love most of all is that it spent that time, I think, selling to a lot of people who wouldn't normally read my books. I get lots of chances to meet my readers, but I do not get chances to meet and interact with my readers for as long as either of us would like. When I've been doing signings in America, the last signing tour I did, we were getting 1,500 to 2,000 people every night, and we were holding it in theaters just with limited numbers of tickets so that it wasn't 3,000 or 5,000 people. Here in France, I signed the other night for 350 people. And the trouble is, you have a limited amount of time to do that. So you get to say hello, you get to sign for them, maybe if you're lucky you give them a hug. But it is not as much interaction as either of us would like. Literary prizes, I've now got all the literary prizes I would ever want. And so, you know, the I think I loved it when Ocean at the End of the Lane got the National Book Award Book of the Year. That was thrilling. But the truth is, I have awards. Mostly what I've been doing is any awards that get to ask you if you want to be nominated or not, I've been saying, no, I'm good. I've got awards. Let people who haven't got awards win the awards because it will make them happier. Well, the next thing that I've just handed in is the last short story in the next short story collection. It's a short story called Black Dog, and it's an American Gods short story. And so that's there. In America right now, Hansel and Gretel has just come out with illustrations by the amazing Lorenzo Mattotti. In England, The Sleeper and the Spindle just came out with illustrations by the amazing Chris Riddell. And they're both fairy stories, but they're very, very different fairy stories. One is a very dark, spare retelling of Hansel and Gretel. One is a very light-hearted, but I hope human, retelling of sort of Snow White meeting sort of Sleeping Beauty.